So we're going to take a look at binding factor pairs. So when we're finding the factors that go with the number, we're really talking about multiplication. So what we need to do is we need to set up the idea of how to multiply and how we can do that with something called an area model. So as you're probably familiar with, area of a rectangle is equal to its length times its width. And we typically introduce multiplication using an area model, or more specifically an array, because everything's equal to 1. So a lot of times what we'll do is if we want to show 2 times 3, we'll tell the student that that's 2 groups of 3. And so they're really creating here a rectangle, and that rectangle has a width of 2 and a length of 3. And that's what gives us our area model. So we're going to use that idea to think about how we can take a number and find 2 of its factors. Let's start with the number 18. If we wanted 18 7 8 12 13 14 15 16 17 18. Okay, so I've got 18 values here, 18 pieces. The thing I have to do with these 18 pieces is create a rectangle so that I can figure out what the length and the width are. So let's say that I wanted to try for a width of 4. If I tried to create a rectangle with a width of 4, what we see is the first 16 fit great, and then we don't know what to do with these other 2 out here. So we can put them up here. Now it's not a rectangle. We can try to put 1 at the top, 1 at the bottom. It's not going to work. The point is, when we have 18 objects, we cannot split that up into 4 equal groups. So 4 is not going to be a factor of 18. Let's look at an example. One of the rectangles that I can make with 18 items would be this rectangle. And what we see with this rectangle is I have a width of 2 and a length of 9. So what this rectangle is modeling is that 2 groups of 9, or 2 times 9, is going to equal 18. So if I'm trying to find the factor pairs of 18, then I can go ahead and I can write down 2 and 9, and I can put those on my list. And I'm not done. The next thing I might do now that I've tried 2 is try 3. So let's see if we can rearrange these and build a rectangle with a width of 3. And we can. So now we see when we have a width of 3, we have a length of 6. So I know 3 and 6 are going to be another factor pair. We already tried 4, so we'll skip that one. Let's try 5. So I'm taking my 18 objects and I'm trying to make them create a rectangle with a width of 5. And you see, we can't. We're too short. And actually what this shows is that 18 divided by 5 would be 3 with a remainder of 2. So we can model division that way, and that's really what we're doing when we're finding factor pairs. We're modeling division. We just have a physical way for kids to be able to manipulate that. We know 5 doesn't work, and now we're back up to 6, and so we know that we found everything. Except for 1, we know we can always have 1 as a factor, and what that means is that I'm probably going to run out of space on my screen, but we could create a rectangle that would have 18 along this row if we could fit them all in. And that would say that a width of 1 and a length of 18 would give us that factor pair of 1 and 18. So now we know 1, 2, 3, 18, 9, and 6 are the factor pairs for 18. Let's take a look at a second example. Let's try the number 9. And if we were asked to find the factor pairs for 9, the first thing I have to do is get 9 pieces that I can use. So I've got my 9 pieces here, and I'm going to start trying to make rectangles. So the first rectangle I'm going to make has a width of 1 and a length of 9. So I know 1 and 9 are going to be a set of factor pairs for 9. Now I'm going to increase to 2. And we see that when we try to create a rectangle with a width of 2, we have 1 left over. So 2 is not going to be a factor. And remember, what this actually shows is that 9 divided by 2 would be 4 with a remainder of 1. Or 4 with 1 that has yet to be divided by 2, which we would write as 4.5. So we can tie it into some other division as well. Let's continue and try for 3. We can create a rectangle that has a width of 3 and a length of 3. And I know I'm done. I know I'm done because I found ones that have no integers in between them. So I know if I go to 4, it's not going to work because I'm kind of starting back on the larger half of the factors. So we know we found all the factor pairs. Just as a side note, this is why 9 is called a perfect square. 9 is referred to as a perfect square because 3 times 3 gives us 9. And a 3 by 3 rectangle is actually a square. So that's why 9 is referred to as a perfect square. The same is true for the 16. 16 is a perfect square because we can show that as 4 times 4, which would create a square for our rectangle. So what we're going to do, and what you'll continue to do with students, is when you give them a number that you want them to find factor pairs for, that will be how many chips you give them. And then the whole question is, can I create a rectangle using all those chips? And if I can create the rectangle, then we're going to ask, what's the length and what's the width? So essentially, we're drawing kids back to the idea of that area model.